Good morning. We're all feeling the effects of crisis and conflict happening all over the world at the moment. Today is Trinity Sunday, the day we as Christians are called to recognize the uniting, community-creating work of God and the love which brings all of humanity together as one.
Holy Trinity of love, will you teach us how to pray? Give us clear direction for our task today. Since we are your body, both your hands and feet, help us be the answer to the prayers we speak. Trinity of love, let us love like you. Trinity of love, let us love like you. For we are not Trinity of love, will you teach us how to sing to remind our world and ourselves you are Lord and King? For we are your mouthpiece, words and melody. Let us be your love song, teach your world to sing. Trinity of love, let us love like you. Trinity of love, let us love like you. For we are nothing. Trinity of love, let us learn to listen well to those who are voiceless and can't speak for themselves. For you are a mother, quick to save her child. Let us be a mother, fearless and defiant. Trinity of love, let us love like you. Trinity of love, let us love like you. Trinity of love, let us love like you.
Matthew chapter 28, verses 16 to 20. The commissioning of the disciples. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end.
2 Corinthians 13. Finally, brothers and sisters, rejoice. Strive for full restoration. Encourage one another. Be of one mind. Live in peace. And the love of God and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All God's people here send their greetings. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Good morning. This is Trinity Sunday, one of the few Sundays we celebrate a doctrine in the lectionary. So, what is the Trinity? Well, it's a complex mystery. Thank you. No, I'm not stopping there. Today's readings contain the origin of some of our most familiar Trinitarian formulations. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you, from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians. And in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, from Matthew. They feel so familiar, almost cosy. But what use is the Trinity to us now? Is it helpful theology, or is it discussing angels dancing on the head of a pin? What feels so familiar now was once hotly contested theology. Were we worshipping three gods or one? How could we make sense of all these references to God, all these different versions of God? The idea of the Trinity fuses this into a single God, represented by three formulations, all of whom are God. I said it was complex. What follows is a somewhat personal theology, which, perhaps to my surprise, embraces the idea of the Trinity. First of all, it's worth pointing out that any human way of describing God can only be deficient. It can't contain all that God is. But as humans, we need to find some way of describing God, however imperfectly, and to do this, we fall back on simile and metaphor. God is love, a shepherd, the way, a vine. What the Trinity does is allow us to describe the way that God is in the world. Let's go back to one of the Genesis creation stories, our first Bible reading for today.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and the darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good.
The word that has been used here is ruach, translated into Greek and used in the New Testament as pneuma. That may sound familiar from words such as pneumatic, pneumonia. It's that idea of wind, breath. But it's also the word used for spirit in the New Testament. Sometimes we use the word ghost. But think of it as pneuma. And what do we have? We have a creation story of God creating a good universe through which pneuma blows. It animates the humans and animals. That's God and spirit. Later in the story, that creator God breathes himself and walks among us in the form of Jesus. Born, lived, breathed, taught, died. There are lots of spirit stories around Jesus and his death and resurrection, and we can often find the wind and breath, pneuma, in them. Remember back to last week, the wind accompanying Pentecost, for example. So the Trinity gives us a creator God who has lived as a human and animates us and creation with the Spirit. Thinking of the Trinity at this time shows up some compelling parallels. What does coronavirus at its worst do? It attacks people's breathing, taking away their spirit. Worse still, the last words of George Floyd were, "I can't breathe." This is where Trinity thinking can lead us. George Floyd was made in the image of God. To look at him is to look into the face of your God, a God who has walked on this earth, and to have had another human being knowingly squeeze the life, the breath, out of him. Any society who can protect or condone the killing of people like this, especially when it happens disproportionately along racial lines, which it does here in Australia, in the US, in the UK, None of those could be Trinity or Spirit societies. So as we take communion together and say our familiar Trinitarian prayers, let us remember that all of those around us are Spirit-filled creations of the Triune God. And wherever there is injustice and discrimination, we are called to speak and act against it as witnesses and prophets. Black Lives Matter.
Well, here we are again. Communion without physical gathering. But this is still the time we celebrate and remember the sacrifice made for us. On this Trinity Sunday, we especially remember that the sacrifice was made for all. Not just the good and the righteous, but for those who don't always start on a level playing field. For those whose lives are a struggle on a day-to-day basis. There's so much unrest and uncertainty in the world today, which is shown currently and constantly in our news reports. But one thing that is always certain is God's love for us, for all of us. On this first Sunday of the month, we celebrate communion. The Lord's table is where his people meet spiritually. And so today we will have an empty hands communion with an empty plate and an empty cup. So I start by saying, the Lord be with you. And so we come to the table. To do so as our Saviour commands, celebrating the redemption he has won for us. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. In this empty plate, we choose to see the world's hunger. We remember that millions of people this day lack bread for communion, bread for breakfast, bread for life. We acknowledge that we ourselves hunger in ways that no earthly bread can justify or satisfy. In this empty cup, we choose to see the world's thirst. We remember that millions of people this day lack wine for communion, fruit for juicing, water for life. We acknowledge that we ourselves thirst this day in ways that no earthly cup can quench. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be fulfilled. Let us pray. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, please endow each of us with the courage and humility of Christ, that his love at work in us may enable us to do much better than seems humanly possible. May his hands take that which is twisted or scarred and shape it for a greater purpose and sublime glory. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen. Make us one with him, one with each other and one in ministry in the world. Pour out the Holy Spirit on this empty cup and this empty plate, that it may be for us, even in their emptiness, the body and blood of Christ. This empty plate reminds us, it is Christ who is the bread of life, who satisfies the hungry heart. This empty cup reminds us it is Christ who is the cup of hope, who revives the thirsty. These empty hands remind us of the gifts of God to the people of God. Take time to receive what you hunger for. Receive what you thirst for, receive your gifts. Let us pray. Lord, we give thanks that this has been no ordinary meal. It has been one in which we have been fed and nourished with the life of Jesus, our crucified and risen Lord. May we know we are one in Christ and be refreshed and eager to share that life with others. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. It's time for our prayers of intercession. Let us pray. Holy friend, we ask for a special blessing for that small community we call our family, with its strengths that nurture or its faults that hurt and inhibit its unity. For that community we call the Church Universal, with its many loves and its numerous failures and even its scandals. For that community we call our circle of friends, with its times of harmony and mutual joy, and its incidents of misunderstanding or neglect. For those communities we call health centres and hospitals and hospices for the dying, with their skills and compassion, yet also their pride and folly. For those communities we call schools and universities, where much knowledge is imparted, but love is not on the syllabus. Holy friend, we ask a special blessing for that multi-ethnic community called our nation, with virtues that make us proud to be Australian, yet also with its prejudices and hurtful ways. For that teeming community we call the world, rich with achievements for the good of all, yet driven by greed, hatred, intolerance, injustice, arrogance and war. Holy Father, thank you for sending your true child Jesus to reconcile all things. By your Holy Spirit, incite all people of faith and goodwill to strive untiringly for that communal harmony where the value of no one is denigrated and where the gifts and successes of each person are celebrated with unstinted gratitude and joy. Holy Father, make us one as we worship you as Creator Father, as Spirit Mother, and as Christ Jesus Son. Three in one, and one in three. Amen.
To love with all thy soul. life let me bring home. Where there is darkness or delight, and where the sadness ever joys. Thank you.